The 57% increase in profit before tax was driven by improved interest margins, which were mainly driven by improved liability mix, which lowered the cost of funds, lower operating costs, strong full-year South Sudan results, personal and business banking, which was able to grow customer balances at rates higher than the total industry, as well as significant growth in trade finance products.
There were costs in 2012 which didn't repeat in 2013, and those were project-related costs specifically. But there was also significant cost discipline within the business in that we were not increasing absolute investment, even though we were operating for a full 12 months in South Sudan, whereas the prior year was only 8 months.
The bank's total income rose 15% to 16.2 billion shillings on account of an increase in fees and commission income, as well as trading revenues. However, there was a decrease in interest income from loans and advances attributed to the bank lowering its base lending rate following the reductions in the central bank rate. The bank says it will be leveraging on corporate and investment banking with focus on oil and gas, as well as power and infrastructure, to drive its business.
What we've sought to do is to create a full service bank with the capability of actually serving customers across all segments and sectors of the Kenya economy. That's both inward investment, outward investment, corporate and institutional investors, as well as individuals, be they high net worth or be they employees of the companies which we also bank.
The bank proposed a dividend payout of 63 cents per share, 12 cents higher than what shareholders received last year. Ruth Mutegi, Business Defined.